My name is Azwan Ismail. I'm from Malaysia. I'm also a LGBT human rights defender. I feel honored to talk after the other human rights defenders of the same cause. I'm a Malaysian poet and writer. I'm the co-editor of Malaysia's first Malay language LGBTIQ anthology, Orang Macam Kita, translated in English as People Like Us. I'm also a human rights defender and activist with Sexuality Merdeka, a coalition of non-governmental organizations and individuals that started as an annual sexuality rights, LGBT rights festival held in Kuala Lumpur, and now has grown into an LGBT rights movement. Sexuality Merdeka means independence or freedom, but the mainstream media, the mainstream newspaper, somehow interpret it as free sex. So we are known as the Free Sex Party, Free Sex Movement. I started to be actively involved with Sexuality Merdeka after the Orang Macam Kita anthology was launched during the Sexuality Merdeka Festival in 2010, thinking that more activism was needed for Malay LGBTIQ people, being the majority of LGBTIQ community in the country. I took the launch of the book as a signal for my increased involvement in the movement. Recently, I was in the planning committee for this year's festival, which has been rebranded as Together Life Gets Better Festival. It was held from 8th until 22nd September recently at various LGBTIQ-friendly venues in Kuala Lumpur. This is the booklet that we have, Together Life Gets Better Festival, with the unicorn on the cover. But going back to 2011, the Sexuality Merdeka Festival was banned by the police and the government due to many police reports made against us by religious and extremist groups. Trucks and a lot of trucks of police arrived at the door of event, the venues of our event, and they are ready to arrest us if we didn't disperse. In 2012, we went to the High Court and challenged the ban, as we feel the ban was wrong and against our rights as defined under the federal constitution. We lost the case as the judge said the ban was purely academical and only for the banning of the festival in 2011. However, we went to court again this year for appeal, but it was not successful. We didn't have the festival last year, but we did have this year, but changed the name to Together Life Gets Better, so that we will not get under the radar, and we also plan and did our festival very discreet. But before that, back to the year 2010. Soon after the festival in 2010, Sexuality Merdeka initiated their own It Gets Better video project, because we were inspired by the same campaign initiated in the US. Basically, the project is to give hope to LGBT people who are depressed and feeling suicidal. And I was featured in one of the videos. My video went viral with over 400,000 views in 2 weeks and over 1,500 comments in a week before the comments were disabled and the video finally put down. Its infamy was probably due to the fact that I'm a Malay and I spoke in the Malay language. In Malaysia, being Malay is equivalent to being Muslim, and the LGBTIQ issue is rarely discussed openly and positively in Malay language, the subject being highly taboo and politicized. Besides, both the penal code and the Sharia laws have statutes criminalizing same-sex sexual acts. For the video, I received many negative feedbacks, including death threats via email, Facebook messages, and SMS. The largely negative coverage in the media, my face were everywhere in the newspaper and numerous websites and blogs. They also quoted many politicians and religious leaders criticizing me, some suggesting that I should be investigated and punished. Sexuality Merdeka, together with its allies, came out with press statements to support me and had also considered to pursue legal action, but the latter had been dropped after considering the unhealthy political scenario in the country. Nevertheless, because of my courageous and controversial It Gets Better video, I was listed among the top 10 gay rights heroes of 2010 by change.org website. This, together with some positive feedbacks, encouragement and support from various parties, including individuals within the local LGBTIQ community, has given me hope to keep on doing what I have been doing. However, following the backlash with the video, I was diagnosed with depression and anxiety, and today still undergo therapy with clinical psychologists. This nevertheless has not hindered me from being a LGBT rights activist and defender, as I feel my work is very crucial and there is still much more need to be done. I also feel very inspired by my fellow human rights defenders after listening to their stories and testimonies. Even though I have not experienced physical tortures and arrest like what they have been facing, I know to a certain extent their mental health or psychological aspects have been affected, like how it affects me. I want to end my testimony by reading what is written in our festival event booklet. Together Life Gets Better is a festival of hope that celebrates diversity, love and harmony. In a world where we encounter intolerance and animosity towards fellow human beings on the basis of sex, gender, class, ethnicity, sexual orientation, gender identity, gender expression, disability and more on a daily basis, it's fairly easy for us to feel demotivated, isolated and indifferent. But together we can rise above it. Together we can create a new world that respects diversity and accepts people for who they are without judgment or prejudice. Together, all of us human rights defenders support each other as we are all actually fighting for the same main cause. We are all fighting for humanity. Thank you.
Thank you very much.